Hey, Colin Smith here from PhotoshopCafe.com, and today I'm going to show you how to make any photograph look better in just a few clicks. This is a technique I call the Euro Glow or the Euro Tint, just because I don't really have a real name for it, but it's something I've been doing for years. It works for people, works for landscape, works for all kinds of photos, and it's basically three steps. What we do is we take the background, we duplicate that layer by hitting Control J, that would be Command J on Mac, or we can just click and drag it into that new layer icon. So what we've got is we've got an extra layer. So there's two different ways we can approach this. One is with the overlay blend mode, and if we look at the overlay, we're going to take our opacity down. That's a little too much. We're just going to pull it up a little bit, and I'm going to bring it down to about there. And in what we're doing, if we look at this before and after, you can see it adds contrast. It darkens the shadows and it richens up the colors in some of the skin tones and things. So if we look at that before and after, that's overlay. The other way of doing it is if we can go into a soft light. Soft light gives you the same effect, but a little bit more subtle. So if we look at that before and after, we might even be able to increase the opacity a little bit on that. Now, hard light does exactly the same thing as overlay in this case. You see that? You don't really see any difference. Okay, so that's the first step. We've been able to do that. Now, the next step we want to do is we want to add a little bit of a blur to this. So if we go up to the filter and we choose blur and we use the Gaussian blur, what we're going to do is just give it a little bit of a blur. Now, you'll notice there's a sweet spot that you'll see. If we do it very low, it doesn't really do much. And then if we go too high, it doesn't really do a lot either. It just starts to look really kind of weird. So what we're going to do is we're going to find a sweet spot in here where there's some kind of a glow going. And I'm noticing it around about 6 pixels for this particular image. Now this is going to change depending on the resolution you're working on. All right, so if we apply this here, now if we look at this before and after, notice the hair can look straw-like and stringy. And when I do this, it gives this beautiful silky hair. And a lot of the time, I might apply this effect just to the hair and mask it into the hair. In this case, it looks a little much in the skin because this particular image I got from Adobe Stock looks like it's a little over-retouched to start with in the first place. So if you do have a little bit of acne and some different things like that, the softening on the skin can really help. Now, we're looking pretty good, but what we want to do is we want to paint back some of these areas here, like the eyes and the lip line. So what we're going to do is we're going to create a layer mask here. And notice we've got that layer mask, and then we're just going to paint with black. So we're going to grab a black brush. So we're grabbing the brush there, make sure black is the foreground color. Make sure the hardness is turned all the way down, so it's a nice soft brush. And what we're going to do is we're going to go, and first of all, we're going to paint over the eyes. So I'm just going to use the right bracket key to make that a little bigger. There we go. See, now I'm starting to get some of that color back in the eyes because we didn't want to darken those all the way in. And we'll make it a little bit smaller, and let's just kind of follow those lines into those tear ducts. And we're just bringing back a little sharpness where we need it. Now, the next place you want is the lips. We don't want to do all the lips, though, because this is a great technique to smoothen out dried chapped lips. So what we're going to do is just follow the lip line in the middle there, and it'll just give that nice little bit of sharpness back there while keeping everything else nice and soft. So if we look at this before and after, you can see we've got a pretty awesome effect there. Now, you can adjust the opacity a little bit lower if you want to make it a little bit more natural. So you can do that. So there we go, before and after. And you can see we get a huge difference. Now, this works on portraits. It works on landscapes. It works on any kind of photo. It's a technique I've been doing for years. And a lot of the time, I will apply this to certain parts of pretty much every photograph because it just makes a dramatic difference in just a few moves. There might be other techniques you want to combine with it. And also, you know, this is just the power of using blending modes. Check out that ebook. I've got a free ebook on blending modes that you can see in the comments underneath. Check that out. It's a lovely little ebook that gives you a lot of information. It gives you examples of all the different blending modes, as well as some practical examples on how to use them. So anyway, I hope you enjoyed this week's episode. It was short and sweet. If you want to be part of the cafe crew, join up by just hitting that subscribe button, and you'll get a new tutorial every single week. Now, if you enjoyed this, hit a like. And also add a comment. Let's get a discussion going. What do you like? What don't you like? And what would you like to learn next? Let me know. So thanks, guys. Thanks for watching. Until next time, I'll see you at the cafe.